Good evening, everyone. It's my humble pleasure and privilege to introduce one of the greatest heroines in the medical field, especially in our area. Dr. Mahadevan, a pioneer of surgery, was a professor of surgery in Manipal. He is one of the authors of that textbook of general surgery, and especially in those times where we have only foreign authors. And he is one of the earliest Indian authors to publish a textbook. His son-in-law, Dr. M.K. Srinivasan, is the director of Public Health Center, a very well-known place to all of us, which is a trust hospital, and now it has upgraded itself into various specialities like pulmonology, nephrology, cardiology, etc. Now I request Dr. Anandan sir to introduce the speaker.
Good evening, everyone, once again. It's a proud privilege to introduce Dr. Kumar. Where is Dr. Kumar? Please come to the table. Dr. Kumar actually is a highly qualified person, but more than his simplicity and humility, I know him for more than 2 decades. He has been a very sincere worker, a sincere practitioner. He is a practitioner in Porur, I'm also in Porur. So a lot of patients, they come and tell me how simple and how philanthropic he is. Sometimes, he gives free of cost to so many patients. And more than that, he is a symbol of patients. I'm telling you, he'll never get angry with patients, never get angry with his colleagues. This is the greatness of Dr. Kumar, which I thought I would share with you more than his quality. He is working in Taproom Sanatorium as a RMO. As an RMO, is working. He is second in command of the previous student. Now, he did his undergraduate from Stanford. He gets a very ultra short CV. I don't give a very short CV, but he has just given it just 4 lines. He did his undergraduate from Stanley Medical College, ETRD from Madras Medical College in 1993, undergraduate in 1986. He did MD General Medicine from Madras Medical College in 1997. He is now at Government Hospital of Thoracic Medicine, Taproom Sanatorium, from 1999. Nearly about 20 years is there. And imagine the experience we should have had on this. In fact, from ESA, our cases we refer, even some difficult tuberculosis cases, we always refer to Dr. Kumar, and he always is patiently with the government. He is a sign of patience and perseverance, actually. That's what I would say. He is also a nodal officer of TB Center, master trainer of NACO. And what is PMDT, I do not know.
Programmatic Mild
Health. Yeah, he is experienced in HIV, he is experienced in TB, experienced in multidrug resistant TB, which I have not that experience. He is really an all-rounder and a very hard worker. We are all very anxious to hear from you. There's a lot of changes taking place in tuberculosis. And even I myself am not abreast to the latest. So I thought we'll hear from the expert person, none other than Dr. Kumar. Please, Dr. Kumar, the stage is yours. Give a big hand, please.
Thank you, welcome, sir. Opportunity to interact with you all, and I thank Professor Anandan. He's my
my senior in my chest program, and also Sandeep, his father is one of the close guided family friend, and also our IMA colleagues, our natural doctor. Thank you. Thank you, and we'll go into the session. I have been working in the TB center for the past 20 years. A lot of changes have come in the program. The program is a public health program where it has got operational research. So all the feedback goes back and the program is changing, always evolving, and slowly it's being upscaled. That I can see from the front. In the field, I've seen the changes happening in the HIV as well as tuberculosis, also in the MDR-TB. So I thought we'll share with you. Before that, we'll go into the general thing. Tuberculosis in our country. So we went way back in 1946 itself, more had told that we have number of cases are more. That time only the SM and PAS came in the 40s, then only the INH. So those days, SM and INH are the mainstay of treatment. That time, more had told that number of beds are less, whereas the patients are more. So we need a mass domiciliary approach, chemotherapy. He has told way back in 46. That time our bed strength was only around 400, now it is 776. So that was the scenario before the independence. And the evaluation is that 1947, the TB division was formed under the Director General of Health, and the BCG campaign in 1951 was a great success, vaccinated many lakhs of children and other things. That was the vaccination. Then we had the 1956, the world famous TRC was established in Chepet. Now it's called research NIRT, National Institute on Research RT. It's renamed as NIRT. Then we had further 1950, the world famous home as a sanatorium trial was done in Chennai. The sanatorium part was the Tambaram, and the home part was near KMC, slum Jagannathapuram. And you can see that the paper was published in the tuberculosis chemotherapy bulletin of World Health Organization that led to closure of many sanatoria all over the world because the cure rate, infectivity rate, the death rate, everything was same in both arms. So that was an important landmark trial, the Madras trial. So then we had the NA in 1916 Bangalore, the NT was established. It was a pioneering center for training all the people, medical, paramedical, all the staff. That training is important in a public health program where monitoring, evaluation, and all the other things, drug toxicity, everything was taken care of by the excellent training happening there. 1962, the national TB program was started. It was mainly a district program based more on the sputum microscopy because of the resources were limited, X-ray machines were not available. So that period, the 1961-86, the 60s, then the ethambutol came, then the rifampicin came, and the pyrazinamide came. So the rifampicin, which came late, was the revolutionary drug. It made the short course chemotherapy made possible. Only 6 months of treatment. So those time it was the 1986 update is the short course chemotherapy era, 1986-93. Before that, the conventional era was 1 year treatment. Everything was 1 year. SM, IMH, ethambutol, all 1 year. Then the short course came after rifampicin, pyrazinamide. Then 1993, because of the DOTS came, that was the change from the daily treatment, it came to DOTS. That was intermittent observed regimen. But those days itself, our professor C. N. Devanagar, who was then Tambaram, he opposed the intermittent regimen. So till his retirement, government couldn't implement that in the Tambaram. Then only after his retirement, slowly he started and it was implemented, it followed suit. But what was the thing was? It was daily short course chemotherapy. The RNTCP was rolled out in 97, revised National TB Control Program because of the failure of the National TB Control Program, and everything was fully implemented towards by 2004, and up to 2017 the intermittent regimen was going on. But it was changed to, as Dr. Anandas had told, it was changed to a daily regimen because of the feedback. What was the feedback was that? Before that, I'll tell you now that everything is in 2017, we have changed the guidelines for diagnosing TB. So now we have made it short, and like the symptoms are, because for the periphery, people from the periphery, remote centers, we made it simple, we have made it like this. Cough for more than 2 weeks, hemoptysis, fever, significant weight loss, any permanent abnormality in the chest. So X-ray chest is now given its due importance. So this is an important thing. Presumptive TB, anyone who has got these things immediately will be suspected. suspected for X-ray and a smear. And also I'm going into the, then the presumptive DRTP is anyone who has a retreatment, whether it is any 1 month more defaulter or cured and relapsed or resistant, all can come under one category. And also previously treated with one category, HIV co-infection is a suspected MDR. Then we have this contact of MDR-TB, pediatric TB, non-responders, all are now called presumptive DRTB. Suffice to say that one side is the presumptive TB, whoever has had exposed to treatment for more than 1 month, on the other side is the presumptive drug resistant TB. So this is a simplified diagnostic algorithm. So this is a simplified diagnostic algorithm, now released by the central TB division. So on the left hand side you see the presumptive TB, on the right hand side all the retreatment, all the diagnosed TB. So what is happening? This initially they thought only we will subject the vulnerable people like the pediatric population, HIV population, then the extrapulmonary for a gene expert, that is a molecular test which has revolutionized the diagnosis of TB. So they thought initially three, then they upscaled it to urban slum and diabetic, five. Now what is the program is now universal drug sensitivity. So in the form of any patient, they will be subjected to CBNAT. CBNAT upfront. Any presumptive TB or diagnosed TB upfront is the CBNAT. So that is the important change that has occurred in the, you are going towards the universal drug sensitivity testing. So the subsequent slides will show you what is the importance of that. So it suffice to say that the CBNAT will be there, done for all the patients. If it is rifampicin resistant means, it is MDR-TB. But only thing is that any new case, you have to take it a pinch of salt. Any new case not exposed to MDR, you have to redo the CBNAT. First test we should not take. Otherwise, retreatment cases, we can straight away take the CBNAT first sample itself as the result. So any rifampicin resistant means is the MDR-TB. You need to straight away be subjected to second LPA. Before going to that, the LPA is another test which has a revolutionized a line probe assay, another molecular test. We will be going into that in the subsequent slides. That has revolutionized the treatment and diagnosis of TB, MDR-TB particularly. So second line LPA means, first line LPA means INH and the bands will come. It is a test where in the nitrocellular paper, electrophoresis, resistant bands will come, the genetic protein is in the mycobacterium tumor. So INH band will come, RIF band come, that is first line LPA. There are no revolution. Again, the second step is the second line LPA where quinolones, which form the mainstay of MDR-TB treatment, on second line injectables like amikacin, canamycin, cabrio, they form a band. So second line LPA directly they will be put into second line LPA. So what is happening? If a patient is diagnosed with a rifampicin resistant TB, they will skip the first line, straight away go to second line, and if they found out whether it is HDR-TB or pre-HDR. Suppose second line means injectable resistant means is a pre-HDR. Both quinolone also resistant means HDR. So in that way, you can within days you can diagnose a HDR-TB. That is put it here. So if the rifampicin sensitive means is the straightforward sensitive TB, not resistant TB, where only we will do a first line LPA. Why means there are some around 1/5 of cases are INH mono-resistance. So in those cases, the National Drug Survey has shown INH resistant patients are also resistant to SM, EMD, etc. Polytherin-resistant. So for the INH, if they diagnose INH mono-resistance, they have a separate 9 months measure. So this is the new thing.
This is actually a very general, I mean, this is, the crowd is not a tuberculosis specialist, so they will not know what the CBNAT stands for.
And
this
or perhaps, in subsequent studies,
CBNAT means the number is, sorry for,
no.
If you don't mind. The previously we should use put a microscopy, acid, fast, fast vascular staining, zeal means staining. Now, this is actually a molecular test, same sputum examination, called scattered based nucleic acid amplification test. It's called Gene Expert. That is a trade name. This is actually a trade name. Yeah, this will tell you not only diagnosis of tuberculosis, very sensitive method actually now. In a straight away put, they said we subject this sputum examination to this test. Next is LPA, line probe assay, is another second stage where again it is a polymer chain reaction or molecular based. These are all molecular based tests, not the usual microbial test. Therefore, this will tell you resistance of both rifampicin and INH. And he has already told out now protoquin also that way. The sign for this interruption, but the change, now there is a big change in the sputum testing actually. AAP No, they directly ask for CV.
Yes.
Did not go for through the CV, I mean, through the AAB exam. They directly go for, because the sensitivity of this, and the patient is almost 189%. Sensitivity 85%. This is the big change has happened in the national. And the cost also has come down. CV being expert cost, if you go to those labs which are recognized, I think there is something called
accredited
labs. There is no employee. Those labs will cost 2,000 only. 2,500.
2,000. It's free of cost in the government.
In the government. In follow private.
Private 2,000, but REACH is doing free, sir.
Yeah.
REACH and NGO is doing free.
So the cost is very factor for this point, but it also gets free by the government. And also our already considered rate for the treated labs. This is what I will just add to this talk.
Sure.
And please go ahead.
So now the daily regimen is this. All daily, 4 drugs in the initial intensive phase followed by 3 drugs. And previously treated patients means 5 drugs for the first 2 months. So already their intermittent norms become daily. And remaining 1 month 4 drugs and followed by 5 months. This is previous category 1 and category 2. So I will be going, so these are the dosage schedule. We previously only 3 weight bands. No more than that 4 weight bands. More accurate dosing. So that the toxicity is minimized and the subtherapeutic doses are avoided. So more than 4 weight bands. I mean speaking even more than 70 kg, they are going to give 750 grams. But in my, our experience, we found out that people don't tolerate more than 600. So that's only observation. So even pediatric, they have a more accurate dosing. So many weight bands are there. So it's a nice thing, revision they have done. So now coming to why the daily regimen. Why we have contact daily regimen means. So the 1/3 of the case, 30% of new smear positive are from India. Almost, but relapse almost 50% are from India. This is the WHO's data. So just to follow this, here the relapses, new smear positive in India, every year from 19 after the DOTS was started, it is slowly increasing. You see now it is almost 15%. The relapse rates in the fresh case, the sputum positive or any fresh case started on the intermittent regimen, the relapse rates are very high. It is the highest in the world. Next slide, you can see it is 15 is now India. All other countries like Afghanistan, 8, 7, like, so the next highest is 7, lowest, sorry, worst. So India is 15. So this operational research has shown that this intermittent 4 drugs regimen is a failure. So that's why we have gone back to the daily regimen. So the relapse rates were very high all over the world. So that was the important thing. So this is regarding the regular treatment which is given for the cases. Now coming to the drug resistance, I thought in the elite audience, I just show you what is the drug resistance, being new things which have happened. Because after 2008, lot of things have happened. Before that, the MDR patients have to be kept in the sanatorium and they were given 1 year treatment, 1.5 years treatment like that. The superintendents and director to the chiefs were giving them their experience, their knowledge of the drugs they were giving. So 1 year smear negative, they will be discharged. 1 year after culture, so that was the case. So patients have to stay away from the family. But after that, funding came in the form of, so these definitions all of you are aware, just for completion, I have put. So history was there, way back in the SMK, that was monotherapy, it failed because fall and rise, the fall of the susceptible organism, because TB and HIV, large number of organisms, they become mutated and resistant, they become resistant, they rise. So even in 1940s, the resistance was there. Now it is more becoming more. So there are new spurts of MDR and in South Africa, XTR came. So those are the things which happened. Now what is that? So just to suffice to say that in our patients, 3% new cases are primary MDR and 12 are second, that is acquired MDR in the retreatment. So just keep in mind, 3% of the fresh cases are MDR by de novo without exposed to drugs, primary MDR, old cases 12. So this 3% now we are going to take care of the doing the ASARTO CBNAT upfront. So all the new cases also we are going to do CBNAT and find out this 3% of primary MDR patients. So multi-drug is now becoming more and more. So that is why it is happening. This is just a what is the definition? Primary is without exposed to drug and acquired is after exposed to drug. Naturally, some of tribes are resistant to some drugs, which are not important in the public health program. So this is how the drug, mycobacterium does this, is mainly creation of nitrogen soil, which prevents penetration of drug into the bunk, and also the enzymes will degrade. Also random genetic, this is the most common. So whenever you are not going to give four drugs and suppress the battery load, random genetic mutation will occur. So this is like, used to say, teach the junior boys, three P's: poor treatment is physician related, poor drugs is program related, poor adherence is patient, all P's, six P's. So this is all how to go about, is the correct dose, right time, right duration, and the counsel the patient on the adherence. But poor drugs is not an issue. Now all the drugs are available. One box is open for one patient, which is there for the entire course. So the program related problems are not there. So we have to go about that. So this is was important thing. After the GFATM, Global Fund Against AIDS TB Malaria, started funding the MDR, we are now gone leaps and bounds. So from 2007, we got it the PMDT, now it's called Programmatic Management of MDR TB. So already sir had alluded to, solid culture is LJ medium. It takes 45 days to grow, 145 days to do the drugs. Turnout time is 90 days. Then came the liquid culture. Even now we are using Digit, Mycobacterium growth indicator, tube is there. Liquid culture is already, or some of you are using in the lab. So it takes 15 days to grow the organism, another 1 month to do the drugs. So it's 42 days. So half of the, even though it is more. So these two are phenotype testing. You identify the bug. Whereas LPL gene exploit are genotypic testing, you are going to identify the genetic material of the bug. So that's why it is all in hours you can get the result. Gene expert in 2 hours, this in 1 day, LPA in 1 day. This is the conventional LJ, all of us read in the microbe. Then this is the revolutionized midget of the liquid culture. There will be trays are there, these tubes will be there. Once the positive means, there will be a few fluorescence will be seen down, the computer will read that. And printout will come after 2 weeks whether growth is not there or not. So this is a BD machine, cost around 55 lakhs. This is a liquid culture. This is also a revolutionary. Then came as a gene expert, cotton based nucleic acid technique, based CBNAT, nucleic acid amplification technique. So you just put the cartridge, sputum or CSF or whatever it is, with the diluent, put the cartridge, cost around 800,000 rupees, put it into the chamber, all process will be there. All this ultrasonic lysis of the thing, everything, DNA is released. Further, printout will come. If MTB detected or not detected. Suppose detected means next step will come. Riff resistance detected or not detected. So multiple probes are there in the machine. One probe will detect the rifampicin resistance, RPO genes. So they will bring out the results. Diagnosis as well as even resistance pattern is known within 2 hours. So that is that. So line probe, as I already told you, it involves more lot of technical thing, and it is strips will come, INH resistance or refraction resistance, and further extension is the second line LPA, where you can find out the quinolone resistance as a second line injectable resistance. So now we are coming to the PMD, just for the benefit of our colleagues. This is the new WHO classification of the drugs. Even now it has changed. Last week bulletin came, but now as on date this is the one. So previously we were using PAS, one physician feels that it's a good drug. No, more evidence, meta is shown. They have done it as group A, that is quinolones. Group B is injectables. Group C is core drug. We have four drugs: etionamide, cyclosine, linezolid, clofazimine. This proclamine and terazoline are pro drugs which are not available in India. So suffice to say, four drugs are the core drugs. C means core. D means, D1 means first line drugs used in second line, pyrazinamide, EMT, high dose IH. D2 is the newer thing, bidaquiline. That's a wonderful drug which has come for our MDR patients. Along with other MDR regimen, first 6 months we will give bidaquiline. 2 weeks, 400 loading, followed by 20 million thrice weekly. Only thing we have to take daily ECG for the first 2 weeks because QT prolongation arrhythmia can come. That's the only drug side effect. And bilamanid is in the pipeline, anytime it will come. So these two are the new drugs. D3 is the desperate, used in desperation. We have PAS because it has been pushed down because of the meta-analysis. Previously we were using PAS, PAS upfront. Now the analysis shown more toxic, less efficacious, pushed down. So we have the imipenem, selastase, meropenem. So imipenem and meropenem are the drugs which are given for MDR. Selastase and coamoxide are the boosters. They are not given alone. They boost imipenem and selastase. This one, meropenem. Only thing they have to be given IV, daily, IV. Okay. Then this is the newer classification of WHO. Now we have seen the diagnostic algorithm. Now the treatment algorithm. Same thing. What will happen? same thing. So CB naught is done first, then we already told you this shorter India region. Now there are 9 to 11 months India. Everywhere they want 2 years WHO judgment, they want to bring it down to whatever ultra short, even 6 to 9 months of India, they are doing 4 drugs. Lulazolid, clofazamine, bedaquiline, they want to cut it down. So when 24 months regimen, more one third only get cured, one third lost to follow up, one third die. Whereas this shorter India regimen, Bangladesh and another 12 countries, 80 to 90% cured has come the short India. So patients pure MDR, they give this. Suppose it's a pre-HDR or HDR, they will give newer regimen. Kinoresin, they will give bedaquiline and 24 months. So this is the important thing that just come. Shorter MDR, everyone we are now giving shorter MDR from March. Only if they are not eligible, we are going for the 24 months WHO regimen. So what, how to go about the drugs, we have been very clearly we have been instructed. So 5 drugs you have to give minimum. So what is that? One from group A, if it is the quinolone, one from group B that is injectable, 2 from the core group. So 4. So the thumb will be the pyrazinamide. If you are able to formulate a good regimen, the man in the palm, then we are not going to go for the risk. This again, all the other new drugs. So we are going for this at present. But the teaching in the abroad and all, they say, use all the drugs. Suppose the patient is diabetic, his BMI is low, extensive TB, use bedaquiline. But our program slowly is being upscaled because of resource constraints. So otherwise, another may not put in, they'll go for the first time, all the new drugs will go. Till then, we'll be formulating only these regimens, 5 drugs for the MDR TB. So this is all the regimens which are there. Actually, I think do not give much. So how to prevent the drug resistance is very, very important. For all the specialties like that, the right dose and the appropriate regimen based on the local international guidelines. So right dose, right time duration. Splitting, some of them we give for convenience, 2 drugs in the morning, today get cured, but there is a chance. So always our teaching is that use the drugs all together. That is the teaching for the junior police. So and something about HIV and TB, because I work in the TB, HIV pioneering center of excellence. The ART has done a miracle. We have seen that the ART has prolonged the duration of life, also the quality of life. From 2004, April 1st, ART is given free of cost for all the patients. We have now second line drugs, third line drugs. So HIV is one way, the TB is the commonest opportunity because celebrity immunity is lost. So the thing is that, sorry, this is a mistake here. The HIV positive is 10% here, negative is 1%. So by Indians, our average risk of getting TB in our lifetime is 10%. Whereas in HIV, Indian, every year 10%. So it's a common thing. So the commonest OA is opportunistic infection in HIV is tuberculosis. So in the thing, the reinfections are common, relapses are common. So one by this vicious circle, HIV accelerates TB, TB accelerates HIV. That is the problem. So these effects of TB on HIV is the CD4 comes down, myeloid increases, so more OAs and death. Whereas now with the AR, the antiretroviral therapy, everything has been totally changed. So it was slowly upscaled. Initially, CD4, our normal range is 700, 1,100. Less than 200, they were giving ART. Then it went to 350 operation, then 500. Now our addiction is find and treat. Whoever is HIV positive, we are immediately starting antiretroviral because the memory cells, if you are not starting early, they are getting impaired. So repeatedly, the patients are getting TB. Once even the quality improves, the quantity improves, 700,000, the quality is not improving because of impaired memory cells. So that was the thing. So because the journey of TB means HIV, we have to tell about the HIV. Now because of the funding, other things, a lot of things are happening, but still on the socio-economic front, many hospitals, attenders are not, they are not admitting. So by one or two, they are coming to our hospital, we have a palliative care ward, a continuum care of our van, continuum of care is there. So many patients disowned by their family and friends, they are here, we are giving them treatment and other things, but still we are not able to give them a full rehabilitation because of the constraints. So I think with these words, I thank all the learned audience for their patient listening. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Kumar, for a wonderful lecture. In fact, as a normally in operation, you don't ask any questions, but
exceptions.
You can always
exceptions.
Exceptions. You can be open to a question. Before he has stopped a long journey from simple regimen to the imperial TV. But I thought I would just, with the permission of Dr. Kumar, I thought I would just add a few highlights. The first thing change is never use for immunodiagnosis of tuberculosis. Previously, a lot of kits have come in the market, what IgG, IgM, please don't use it anymore. Government of India has banned, and therefore the immunodiagnosis of tuberculosis is now out. So we can instead use the gene expert, and this is more, it's a well-known, it's now replaced the immunodiagnosis. The other thing is that the category 1, 2, 3 has gone now. Now it is only 2, it is new cases and retreatment cases. So we are very simplified, and from intermittent to daily regimen, as rightly told, and all the medicines are given one tablet will have one tablet, two tablet, three tablet like that, depending on the weight. All the medicines are there in one single tablet, all the four drugs. And then they have also increased the duration of treatment. They made from intermittent to daily, and I think they have not increased the duration of treatment, no? Six months.
Only 6 months, but they can extend it by 3 months.
Until
any residual lesions, then 3 months
they
can extend.
Yes, up
and
to 9 months.
Also, 4 TB and Euro TB, they can extend by another 3 months, up to 9 months.
Correct. Previously, it was only 6 months, now they can extend. The program allows you to extend by another 3 months. The information comes to us, and they say we can give for 3 months. The previous drug regimen was 4 drugs in the first 2 phases of treatment is there for tuberculosis. Intensive phase and continuation phase. This is the basic. The fundamental treatment is intensive phase and continuation phase. Intensive phase is usually 4 drugs, and continuation phase 2 drugs was given in the previous program. Now it is 3 drugs. They found that 2 drugs, INS comes is not enough. Therefore, they are giving 3 drugs in the continuation phase, and you can extend up to 9 months. This is the little change. The other thing, gene expert, you can do it even on tissues. There are a lot of extra pulmonary tuberculosis which has come. Extra pulmonary tuberculosis, even bone tuberculosis. This gene expert can send a specimen, not in normal saline, for gene expert. Please use that. You can use CSF. Chlorophyll also can use, but sensitivity is very less. Never use gene expert for blood. Please remember that. I think blood specimen, never use for gene expert. You can use it for sputum, you can use it for CSF, you can use it for tissues also. They're very, very. I found the pickup rate is very high. It is found that this is really the change in the diagnostic modality. We have resolved a lot for our cases to diagnose, and we are very happy that we can confidently, some cases are open, clearly seen, but some cases we have doubtful cases are there. Gene expert is very useful, and there is something called induced sputum. It may not be that. Regarding MDR TB and HIV, the combination, better to leave to Dr. Kumar and Sandra Bill, because they got all the infrastructure, it's not easy to do at the patient level. The only thing you have to suspect early if they are doing. That's why we got gene expert. Thank you very much for the patient here. Yeah, please.
Previously, tuberculosis of the bone, we were given 1.5 years treatment. Nowadays, what is the current treatment of tuberculosis of the bone? One. Second thing, what is the easiest method to find out to diagnose the drug resistance?
Sir, with permission of the speaker and auditor, I'll make the 2 observations and answer this question. Perhaps it is too early to replace the direct observation of AFB by CPNAT, because the direct observation of AFB as a process, you are identifying the microorganism. You are seeing the microorganism, whereas CBNAT is only seeing the product of the microorganism, cells by the mission. Of course, in our medical practice as well as commercial and social practice, we are giving away the human involvement to the machine involvement more and more in many spheres. From that point of view, perhaps CBNAT will be the better advantage, but still I feel we too early to give up the AFB. Second, the duration of all this treatment for the national program purposes, definitely they have to differ. sitting in the chair of an administrator as well as executor of the government. He is not only administrator but executor of the government, government of Tamil Nadu and all these programs. You define the date and time. But individual clinical practice is one to one. You go by the progress of the patient. How is this? Today we have got so many methods of assessing the progress of the patient. Perhaps the progress of the patient is slightly delayed. There is nothing wrong in extending the duration of treatment or anything. And with respect to the bone and neurotuberculosis, I gave a suggestion to my colleagues in earlier two medical conferences. You do a thesis on what our fellows did earlier, including Prasadandaram and Jagannath and Ramamurthy, what they did in neurotuberculosis, including the Natarajan and others, what they did in bone tuberculosis. You make a thesis of it and then compare it to the present thing, what we are doing. Perhaps what our brothers and elders did earlier also may come back later. Therefore, these are 3 points I will leave it to them to answer. Sir, I extend bone tuberculosis for 1 year and 3 months.
Previously, you are giving us only minimum of 1 year, sir. Now the newer drugs may be 1 year minimum, but it depends as 1-to-1 merits and demerits of the case we extend. Regarding the diagnostic, X-ray and smear were first, sir. X-ray and smear as Sharp told. Then gene expert because in place of universal drug sensitivity testing, we are doing gene expert. That is a UDST. And there is now new entries called clinical TB. Previously, no empirical now. If a physician feels X-ray suggests of TB, gene expert negative, smear negative, he can start clinical TB protein treatment. That provision now they are given in these revised guidelines from November. So clinical TB, the physician can start the treatment.
The community on Deina treatment.
Yes, sir.
Now we are accepting that Deina is a great
full person. Circle. Yes. Now just come back to that.
Sir, what is the continuous treatment? Three drugs. What are drugs?
INH rifampicin and ethambutol, sir.
Ethambutol is not a given for more than 2 months, they say. Because of
We have to do a ophthal examination if there is any problem. I'm not routinely done in the program, but you are seeing case of optic neuritis with ethambutol. We have to be careful, sir. But regarding the thing, pyrazinamide only 2 months they are stopping. But some of our senior colleagues, because of diabetes, HIV, they are giving 90 days, but does not come in the program. They say early sterilizing effect, intracellular organism only. So pyrazinamide is withdrawn after 2 months because the population of intracellular is less. But ideally, as you are told, even 90 days of pyrazinamide is better, but not in the program.
Resistant bone tuberculosis. Gene expert is still the method, both for sputum as well as extra permanent tuberculosis as well as permanent tuberculosis. Gene expert, please. If I am resistant is detected in gene expert, think about the at least this resistance, the suspect.
Just to add to that, I have my surgical colleague, Dr. Varanapani, was working with us in the TB hospital. We used to do, if the resources are there, one portion of normal saline in gene expert, another normal saline in liquid culture. Third is the HP, so one by one, so gene expert will be there, liquid culture within 2 weeks result will come. Third portion with formalin will go to HP, sir, that if the resource is perfect. Otherwise the program only gene expert has to. So liquid culture is another armamentum we have for extra pulmonary, yes. Clinching as well as drug resistance will come once the sensitivity pattern comes. But it will take 1 month time. 15 days, you know, positive or negative. So like that we used to do, but only it depends on the resource. Available resources.
Nando is completely given up.
No, it is there, sir. Only for like the IGRA, it is there. To whether we are exposed negative matto sometimes in the sarcoid, gives us some more.
Nando,
no, routinely the program it is not there. DST is not there.
International matter only for up to 5 years.
Regarding the status of matto as of now, is matto is only used in the program mentioned for pediatric latent tuberculosis.
Yes.
I think
for
latent tuberculosis. Latent tuberculosis means the patient who rheumatoid arthritis, putting on this biologicals and immunosuppressive drugs, you have to get a platelet tuberculosis. So this is not just, I must tell you that latent tuberculosis is one, and various silicosis, they have latent tuberculosis. Those who are immunosuppressive drugs, perhaps those who are diabetic doesn't come into that category, but those who are, these are all latent tuberculosis can occur. In latent tuberculosis, regimen is slightly different. I think latent tuberculosis, you are not.
We are not, we are type casting.
Yeah, latent tuberculosis is very important because many times they come to us, patients are inverted, or they have got a lot of autoimmune diseases who are put on immunosuppressive drugs. They come to the TB specialist, or they come to our department to know whether there is a latent tuberculosis or not. In that case, Bantu is very effective.
But they are not react, no? They are
immunosuppressive. If Bantu is positive,
before starting the we will do a Bantu or IGRA.
Correct.
If it is more positive, means they are exposed to the bacilli, latent LTB may be there inside. Yeah. So we will be giving a chemotherapy when the immunodirect drugs is given. Immunotherapy is given, they will be given a anti-TB treatment to prevent the breaking news.
See, this is the standard protocol now. Before starting immunosuppressive drug, we have to send to a physiologist. Just physician is consulted whether any latent group is there or not. So before starting immunosuppressive drugs, if it is positive, that is where the Bantu comes and gold interferon test comes. Both tests are for directly latent tuberculosis. If it is positive, then we have to give empirical treatment, we have to give treatment to suppress the latent tuberculosis. Because there is several problems, there are various regimens there. INS for 12 months, INS rifampicin for 6 months. Okay, like that, treatment of latent tuberculosis is there. There the Bantu is very important. But still I give a lot of importance to Bantu, though it is not there in the program, but still it is got a equal value. You cannot totally ignore Bantu. Please use it for latent tuberculosis. Particularly in your general malignancies, you just start on immunosuppressive drugs. You like to know whether you have tuberculosis or not. Because Bantu is strongly positive, you can add the regimen for latent tuberculosis, which is different from all these. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Now we request Dr. Perumal Swami to come forward and add a certificate to Dr. S. Kumar. Please, sir.